Hello everyone! Do you know about the connection between dehydration and headaches? We can hardly find at least one person who has never had a headache in their life. And when it appears, you have only one task: to get rid of it as soon as possible. And dehydration can be one of the common causes of headaches. It is simple and at the same time not obvious. During a migraine attack, you may not feel thirsty. However, dehydration can play a role in decreased concentration, irritability, and migraine as well. So, in today's video, I will answer the question: how does water intake affect headaches? Producers of bottled water are constantly ringing us about the need to drink water, but both children and adults often forget to drink water during the day. I have found some articles on the role of water in headaches. A dehydration headache is also called a water deprivation headache. In the study of water deprivation headache, subjects needed an average of 500 to 750 ml of water and from 30 minutes to 3 hours to relieve headaches caused by a lack of water. In a pilot study on the effectiveness of water in preventing headaches, patients were advised to drink an additional 1.5 liters of water for 12 weeks. Even in the 2 weeks of the study, there was a 21-hour reduction in the total headache hours. The average intensity of headache also decreased after increasing the amount of water intake. However, the effect of water on the number of headache attacks and on medication intake was negligible. Another study demonstrates that in healthy young women, moderate levels of dehydration lead to adverse changes in key mood states, such as alertness and fatigue. Dehydration also leads to increased headaches and difficulty concentrating without significantly altering key aspects of cognitive performance. There is little evidence in the scientific literature that not drinking can lead to headaches and migraines, but you can do your own research. Some of the signs of dehydration are weakness, dizziness, palpitations, confusion, dark-colored urine, and fatigue. The problem is that during a headache, you may not notice any dehydration symptoms, not realize that you are dehydrated, and not even feel thirsty. However, try increasing the amount of water you consume and observe your condition. Such a simple act, drinking pure water, can reduce the intensity of the headache or get rid of it altogether. I cannot give you a general recommendation like you should drink 2 liters of water per day, or you should drink 20 to 30 milliliters of water per kilo of weight per day. The amount of water varies greatly from person to person and depends on weight, gender, physical activity, functioning of the cardiovascular system, urinary system, gastrointestinal tract, menstrual cycle, the presence of a particular disease, etc. If you play sports or other activities that cause fluid loss through sweat or urine, you should increase your water intake. If you have diseases of the cardiovascular system and kidneys, then you should limit your intake of water. In any case, the amount of water should be discussed with your doctor. And now a message for especially inventive people. Keep in mind that you should drink pure, non-carbonated water, not sugary sodas or alcoholic drinks. Alcohol leads to severe dehydration and as a result might provoke headaches. Conversely, some drinks such as coffee can cause headaches when you stop taking them. Unsurprisingly, there is currently so little data on the effects of dehydration on headaches and migraines. Clinical trials cost thousands, millions of dollars, and pharmaceutical companies are not interested in researching free or cheap water. Moreover, patients themselves consult with doctors only to get the medicine for the headache and not to find out the cause of their condition. Just imagine that in response to your headache complaint, your doctor recommends that you should simply drink more water. What do you think? Will you follow this recommendation? Evidence-based medicine focuses on the addressing the superficial symptom of the disease, not the underlying cause. We will go deeper. In the following videos, I will analyze other possible causes of headaches and migraines. Stay with me, subscribe to my channel, take care of your body, mind, and head.